Hey guys, what's up? Got another wrestling talk video for you. Got some set pieces now. This one's gonna be about not a review of like any particular episode. It's more it's weird problem they're having with a specific character whose name is Alexander Rusev. I'm gonna be putting up a lot of pictures during this video just so you can have a bit of a visual aid with some of the things I'm gonna be talking about. Just for backstory, WWE is an American-based product. So we have characters who are very nationalistic, and that's kind of their whole gimmick, is that they like America a lot. And then, to make bad guys, the easiest way to do it is just make somebody who doesn't like America. So you'll have like a Russian guy, or a Japanese guy, or even a group of Canadians. You know, we've had so many, it's not even funny. I probably couldn't even list them out if I tried and had like a Wikipedia page, we'd be here all day. So, now we have the newest offerings from the We Don't Like America foreign powerhouse type of guy, and his name is Alexander Rusev, or just Rusev now, I suppose, because they don't like having two names. But his whole thing is that he's from Russia. He is just an awesome athlete, and like to the extent that, in the show, Russia saw how great he was and was like, dude, we can give that guy a medal. So on Raw, they gave him a medal. It was like this whole ceremony thing, and they just kind of let it happen. But, yeah, he is just this amazing Russian athlete, and he has a sidekick with him, and her name's Lana, and she's pretty much his mouthpiece, the person that talks for him. And she goes out there and says how stupid America is and how much they suck, and then how great Rusev is and how Rusev's going to crush everybody in his way. And Rusev does. Rusev kicks the shit out of people. And, like, as you've probably seen from the pictures, he is built like a small brick shit house, but goddamn can he move fast. Like, I'll get more into it later, but the character he's supposed to be is kind of an Ivan Drago type of guy where nobody can really stop him. He's just on a fucking crash course through WWE, just destroying everything in his path. But the problem is, I don't dislike him. And not even in a concept of, oh, I'm being contrarian, or I like his in-ring aspect too much. So the main issue I'm having with him right now is he's been in the main roster of WWE for around about... You want the toy? He's been in the main roster for about 6 months. Around about that time, because he came in... Yeah, about 6 months. And his first feud was just against a couple jobbers. You know, he faced R-Truth and Xavier Woods. And then he moved on to facing Big E Langston. And they changed the whole dynamics of that to be a nationalistic thing, because Big E was on the American powerlifting Olympics team, and Rusev was on the Russian. Not at the same time, I don't think. But it just became USA versus Russia. And they had a feud that lasted 2 months. So they were butting heads for almost 2 months. And then after Rusev beat him twice, he moved on to Jack Swagger. Jack Swagger gimmick it used to be, before he was a good guy, was that he was a racist, essentially. He's like, oh, get them back over the border! Get all these people out of here! He got Zeb Coulter, who's like this really redneck-sounding guy, and he looks like Yosemite Sam. I think I've talked about it before. But essentially their gimmick is that they don't like foreigners. But now they're good guys because they don't like the right... Because now they don't like the correct foreigner. So they're allowed not to like this guy, because I don't know, it's okay now. So then they have a feud that lasts 2 months. And during this feud is when I really kind of started to like him, because he does something a lot of guys really don't do anymore, and that's act like they're hurt. Like, he is this unstoppable monster who is, for all intents and purposes, he doesn't have to act like anything hurts him. I mean, he's just bowling through people. But Jack Swagger's, one of his main finishers is the ankle lock, where he just like grabs your ankle and just twists it around as much as he possibly can and try to like rip it the fuck off or something. And Rusev gets that put on him and like three or four times in one match before he finally wins, but he only wins by count out. And like whenever he's celebrating his victory, he's not even putting any weight on that ankle. He's pretending like he fucking got his ankle almost ripped off. So then over the course of the next month that they're still having their feud, Rusev is still nursing this ankle. Like, he still is saying how much this hurts. I mean, Jack Swagger barely acknowledged the fact that he had a 300-pound person sit on his back and, like, try to fold him in half like a taco. But this guy gets his ankle twisted a little bit. He's still pretending it hurts. It goes a long way. Because you'd imagine, like, yeah, somebody fucking does that to you, it's going to hurt. But it's just amazing how little people actually acknowledge, wrestlers actually acknowledge that. And like Rusev will be going to like do his little jump kick, but then he'll get stopped because his ankle hurts. Or he'll go to like do his accolade, which is where he just like he stomps on you, he sits down, he like pushes, like just pushes you back. I have pictures of when I don't know why I'm pantomiming. And it just, he's so, like you can see in his face it hurts to have this on there because it hurts his ankle too. But he's gritting through it. He's determined to win. And that's where it kind of comes into play, where it's hard for me not to at least acknowledge him as a good competitor when he is trying so hard. Like, it's not like he's a chicken and, like, he only fights when it's necessary. It's not like he's cheating to win. He is winning fair and clean, and he is pushing through obstacles. Like, he is essentially him against the entire nation he's in. And, like, he's nursing injuries, and he's still just beating everybody handedly. So now he goes to his next feud against Mark Henry, another guy who is an Olympic athlete, and he's the world's strongest man. And he outweighs him. Mark Henry outweighs Rusev. He is taller than Rusev, and he is, by all accounts, stronger than Rusev because he is the world's strongest man. And Rusev beats him. I mean, they have a good like, over the course of the rivalry, they have back and forths where one guy will get the upper hand, the other guy will get the upper hand, but whenever it comes down to it, at their match at Night of Champions, Rusev wins. He doesn't cheat. He doesn't exploit an injury. He doesn't use, like, chicken shit tactics. He just wins. He just is better than Mark Henry. And, I mean, it's good. Like, Mark Henry almost refused to tap out, but he just had to. The next night on Raw, they had their rematch, and that time Mark Henry straight up refused to give up, and that's what he said. He goes, "I'm not giving up this time," and the ref had to stop it because Rusev had this accolade in there, his little camel clutch thing, in for so long that ref's like, "All right, we're done here." And it's just, he's overcoming odds. He's overcoming obstacles. He is going through all of this stuff, and he's not cheating. All he's really doing is being a dick about it. And you can't really begrudge somebody for that when you have guys come out there and say, like 300 million Americans hate you, and I'm going to kick your ass. Like, well, I'm going to kick your ass, and all those Americans are stupid. And because, obviously, he's going to kick his ass, because he's done it for a month straight. He hasn't gotten pinned or made to tap out the entire time he's worked here. The only thing that's happened is he's got disqualified like twice. And what happens next is on SmackDown, Rusev faces Mark Henry's good friend, The Big Show, who is 7 foot tall, 500 pounds, and he's the... So now Rusev, who is... I mean, he's a big dude, but he's not as big as The Big Show. And now he has to face The Big Show. And The Big Show does beat him, but only by disqualification. And then after the match, Big Show decides to knock him out, like, because he's got like he's got a fist the size of my goddamn head. If I get hit by that, I'm getting to knock the fuck out. And that's what Big Show's thing is. He just punches you in your fucking face and you go down. Down, son. So yeah, he knocks him out after the match. He can't beat him clean, so he knocks him out. So it's kind of like, Big Show is supposed to be the good guy here. And yet he's attacking people after the match because he can't win. So then they keep... Then the next night on Raw, Rusev comes out, he wins a match, and Big Show comes out to interrupt his victory. Because every time Rusev wins a match now, he like stands there, he's like, yeah! And then you hear the sound of fireworks go off, and the Russian flag, like this giant fucking gigantic Russian flag, falls down from the ceiling and just hangs there in the background. And like he gets to celebrate, like, okay, fuck it, he won, why not? Everybody else gets to stand out there for 20 minutes going, I'm the winner, I'm the winner. You can have a flag fall down, whatever. And he's done this, you know, for, I think ever since he's been fighting Jack Swagger, he's, every time he wins a match, he has this flag drop down. So he beats this guy, Big Show comes out and chases off Rusev, but then he grabs the flag and rips it down. Not that I have a problem with them doing stuff like that. Like, I don't have any kind of nationalist pride or, like, sympathy like that. But it's just weird that Rusev won clean. He beat him fair and square. He has the right to put that up there by all means. And Big Show, like, rips it down and, like, stomps on it. Like, that, it just seems like a dick move, you know? Like, imagine if, like, if Jack Swagger, every time he won a match, the American flag came down and just... for no reason, some fucker just ran out there and ripped it down. You'd be like, that guy's a dickhead. Like, that's just kind of how I felt. Like, Big Show's a dickhead. Just kind of ripped his shit down. So then, like, they send Big Show off to sensitivity training because I guess the internet was kind of in a buzz about, like, oh, they're fucking racist and shit. And WWE's just like, oh, fuck me. I didn't give a shit about that. It was just, I don't understand how Rusev was supposed to be. I don't know how Big Show is supposed to be the good guy when he's being a dickhead like that. I mean, sometimes good guys can be the jerks, but at least most of the time they have it founded in the right. Like, most of the time they have a reason to be a dick. But this time it's just because nobody's beat him, so they're just being a dick to him. Like, it just comes across like he's facing everybody else, like he's the only person, like he's against the odd, he's the underdog almost. If he wasn't kicking the shit out of everybody in his path, he'd almost be the underdog. And it's just, yeah, the dynamics are so wrong because he's just beating all these guys completely fair, and yet everybody still tries to say he's an asshole. And it's only because he's from Russia. And he says, so then this week it's Big Show versus Rusev. They finally are, like, clashing for real now instead of just talking back and forth at each other. And Rusev comes out there. Big Show comes out there. They have a match. Big Show comes out like a fucking ball of fire and starts, like, just absolutely smothering Rusev, just kicking his ass, just smacking him every fucking where. But by the end of it, Rusev finds a way to overcome the world's largest athlete and win. He puts him in the accolade and Big Show refuses to tap out. So, like, Mark Henry has to kind of go in there and throw in the towel for him. Metaphorically speaking, he goes in there and shoves Rusev off and they call the match no disqualification. Rusev was going to win anyway, so it doesn't really matter how he was going to win. But then Big Show and Mark Henry corner Rusev, who, like, is holding his, like, Russian flag, like, on a pole. And they corner him and Lana, and, like, Rusev is, like, standing there all defiant. He, like, looks over at Lana and, like, hands her the flag, and he, like, says something in Russian towards her and bows her head, and she's, like, she bows her head back, and he, like, goes at fucking Big Show and Mark Henry, the world's largest athlete and the world's strongest man, attacking one dude who is, they are both taller, they are both stronger than, and they're supposed to be the good guys. Rusev is standing up for what he believes in, going against the odds, and not backing down from any challenge, and he's the bad guy. It's just, it's all fucked. Like, it's just wrong. It's just, maybe it's some kind of weird, subtle fucking commentary on world wars and shit and America as a whole. Like, and maybe we're just not supposed to catch on to that, but it's just, if I'm not supposed to like Rusev, you're doing it fucking wrong. That's the point of the video. is if I'm not supposed to like this guy, you need to make him unlikable. Because right now, he is the underdog. He is a fighter. He is what a fucking wrestler is supposed to be. And he's not anything less. So, yeah. That's all I wanted to say. It's just how fucking easy. It's easy. You make the good guy really good and make him want to cheer for it, and you make the bad guy an asshole. But right now, the bad guy is not an asshole. He is an asshole. There's that. That's one thing against him. But everything else, he's just a competitor. He's going to talk shit because he can back it up. He wins all of his matches cleanly. He doesn't cheat, as I've said like 60 times now. But it's just to get this through. There is no reason why I shouldn't dislike him other than the fact that he is Russian. And there's some flaw with that.